Most of the research in my lab stems from a really fundamental question that I'm fascinated by, which is how do molecules within cells self-organize, and how does that type of specific organization lead to cellular function? And we're specifically focused on understanding this problem in the context of cell signaling. So cell signaling is the process by which cells sense information in their environment and adapt to changing environmental conditions. This process of cell signaling starts at the plasma membrane, which can be thought of as the barrier between the inside and the outside of the cell. But it's also a really complex dynamic signaling platform where molecules are embedded within the plasma membrane that can sense signals and initiate cellular changes to these signals. So we're interested in understanding how do these molecules assemble at the plasma membrane, how do they organize, and how does their organization then lead to changes in cell behavior. There's lots of different ways that cells are organized. So eukaryotic cells, which are human cells, are sort of defined by their ability to form organelles. So these are compartments in the cell that have membranes. But that's not the only way that organization can arise. So you also can have organization arise simply from the way that molecules interact with each other. So actually, part of my research is interested in understanding how you can form a compartment without a membrane. And that leads to this phenomenon of phase separation. There's a lot of different types of biological molecules that have a propensity to phase separate and sort of condense to form a liquid droplet. So it's a way to form a discrete compartment without having to rely on membranes. What I found in my research is that the same phenomenon of phase separation can also occur at the plasma membrane. So it's a way that you can concentrate receptor molecules that are embedded within the plasma membrane with a specific subset of other biological molecules to form this compartment on the plasma membrane that has a host of different molecules, maybe that all are participating in the same pathway. So we're interested in how signaling pathways are functioning in normal cells, but also understanding how are these pathways, these same pathways, being sort of hijacked or misregulated in diseases like cancer or heart disease. This is a very new area of research, and there's a lot of excitement in the drug discovery world about understanding all of the ways in which phase separation might be used in the cell. Because I'm so interested in spatial organization, ultimately microscopy is at the heart of what I do. That's what got me interested in research as an undergraduate and is like one of the threads of my research throughout all of my training. We can label molecules and look at them in living cells to see where different molecules localize in space and time and how they relate to other molecules of interest. Another way of understanding organization is taking molecules out of cells and trying to understand them in a test tube. And it also enables us to design new tools that we can use to study these molecules in cells. The process of taking something apart and putting it back together can be very helpful in understanding how something works. So there's lots of different components that people have shown contribute to organization and signaling at the plasma membrane. And I really hope that my research is able to get a complete view, a complete understanding of how all of these different factors work together to ultimately dictate organization and therefore dictate function at the plasma membrane. I also am myself a fairly interdisciplinary scientist, and I really value interdisciplinary skills. So I think my lab will be strongest when we have a group of people with diverse training backgrounds as well. Then we'll be able to learn from each other and sort of strengthen the group's abilities together.